Students, myself Deepak Kumar Chaudhary welcomes you all in this inspirational, motivational and informative video. Let us start with this quotation, that is, there is no friend as loyal as a book. In this video, we will explore and share some unknown facts about NCERT, you know very well. So let us begin this short journey. Dear aspirants, you must have come across these logos whenever you have opened your NCERT books of any subjects and of any standards. These are the logos, or you can say hallmarks, of our NCERT books. So dear students, let us explore some interesting facts about NCERT. So first of all, what does NCERT stands for? NCERT stands for National Council of Educational Research and Training. NCERT, that is the National Council of Educational Research and Training, is an autonomous organization of the Government of India, which was established in 1961 as a literary, scientific and charitable society under the Societies Registration Act. Its headquarters are located in Sri Aurobindo Mark in New Delhi, and Dr. Hrishikesh Senapati is the director of the council since September 2015. And the Human Resource Development Minister, Mr. Ramesh Pokhariyal, is the present president of NCERT. Let me share the historical aspect of NCERT. Government of India's Ministry of Education resolved on 27 July 1961 to establish the National Council of Educational Research and Training, which formally began operation on 1st of September 1961. The council was formed by merging seven existing national government institutions, namely the Central Institute of Education, the Central Bureau of Textbook Research, the Central Bureau of Educational and Vocational Guidance, and many more. The design of the NCERT logo is taken from an Asoka period relic of the 3rd century BCE. The motto has been taken from the Isha Upanishad and means life eternal through learning. The intertwined hansas symbolize the integration of the three aspects of the work of NCERT, which are research and development, training and extension. The council's objectives are: the first one, to promote and conduct educational research, experimentation of innovative ideas and practice. Number two, to develop National Curriculum Framework, that is NCF, syllabi and textbooks, teaching learning materials and kits. Number three, training of pre-service and in-service teacher education and national and state level functionaries. And in number four, to collaborate with the state, national and international organization. Textbooks published by NCERT are prescribed by the Central Board of Secondary Education, that is CBSE, from classes 1 to 12, with exceptions for a few subjects. Online textbooks can be downloaded for free from the ePaathshala website. It is quite necessary for nowadays, because NCERT books are not physically accessible to most of the learners due to pandemic COVID-19. Now, dear learners, let us distinguish between the NCERT and CBSE on the basis of their objectives and working profile. The first one, NCERT stands for National Council of Education, Research and Training, whereas CBSE stands for Central Board of Secondary Education. Number two, NCERT assists and advises the central and state government on school education system, whereas CBSE implements all the policies and maintain a standard in education. Number three, NCERT do not run schools. It is governing body in schools education, whereas CBSE run schools and prescribe NCERT books. Number four, NCERT are responsible for the improvement of education in schools, to collaborate with the state, national and international organizations, whereas CBSE are responsible for implementation of rules, conducting and evaluating exams, affiliation to schools. And in number five, NCERT publishes books for CBSE board, innovation in education, develop syllabus, training of pre-services and in-services, ICT materials, etc., etc. Whereas Central Board of Secondary Education put reforms in exams and evaluating practices, learning methodologies and innovations in teachings. Dear learners, in this video we have discussed few salient features of NCERT. It is hoped that you have enjoyed this video. Keep learning and thanks for your time.